In a Mori poll done, a large percentage of young Muslims said the Imam is totally clueless about our society. And that's what we want to turn around tonight, inshallah. That there's some Imams, we're not clueless, we're on the road just like you're on the road. But our way on the road is different from the road you're upon. Has it not become, unfortunately, a common trend that Muslim youth, they drink alcohol, whatever the names may be, whiskey, brandy, rum, vodka, beers, ale, whatever it may be. Common practice that Muslims get drunk, get legless, can't find their way home, abuse other Muslims while they're making their way home. At least some people used to drink, they used to drink in secrecy, drink in the privacy of their own homes. But now we find that people out in the open, behaving like disbelievers. But then some Muslims may say, well, you know, I don't drink alcohol. I take some mild substances. I smoke drugs. Tell me in the Quran, where Allah said in the Quran that cocaine, crack, smack, weed, skunk, marijuana, spliff, reefer, dope, white lady, coke, smoke, brown, Charlie, whatever name you want. People say to me, give it to me from the Quran and I'll give it up today in my life. Man taking heroin, lying on the floor like a dog. Addicted to heroin, lying on the floor, picking up cigarette butts, chewing them because he's become a skaghead. That's how low our community's fallen down. When you see your own brother falling on the floor, picking up small cigarette butts, begging from another Muslim to go get another wrap, to inject themselves. A man wants to drive by in his flash car and think, yeah, I'm a big boy. When some people are serving these substances, there's a code of behavior. Never serve it up to another Muslim. Never ever in your life. Go down a long way. Go down a long way, but never ever get your own blood addicted to it. We've crossed over the rules. We've crossed over the boundary. Some of us, we think we're gangsters. Read about the gangster world. Read about the Gambini family, the Don Corleones that you want to be. Forget about Tony Montana, the Cuban drug dealer who came over. The real drug dealers, you read about the cartel. Man would never serve drugs in his life. Read the history of the gangland warfare. No real Italian mafia ever served drugs in their life. Any man caught trafficking drugs, then he was gunned down by the mafia. That's the ethics you will know about the gangland mafia. That's the reality. But obviously we turn and look at people like the Scarface. Muslim boys walking about with a picture of Scarface with a zoot in his mouth. Go and read the history of Scarface. Who was Scarface? Even read the history how he got the name Scarface. Some people say he got battered so much and called him Scarface, he hated the name. So he ended up dealing with a man. Now the historians are right. They went, he said something about next man's woman. Man turned around, scarred him up in his face, he can remember it for the rest of his life. He looks in the mirror. He said these evil statements. But what was the end of this individual? What's the end of all these individuals begins to take place inside their life? We begin to praise them, look up to them. That this is my lifestyle. Live by the gun, die by the gun. That's what some of us we think, isn't it? The gangster rap culture as well. Listening to these people. Man walking with his trousers hanging below his bottom. Think he's Tupac Amaru Shakur. Amaru means what? The shining serpent. That shining serpent is where now? Wrapped round his mouth. All eyes on me now, isn't it, Tupac? I get around, isn't it? Damn hell you get around. Gunned down, 1996, four times a drive-by shooting. Hail is the greatest rap artist that ever existed, selling 75 million albums, or 75 million recordings of his. His famous album being Machiavelli, when he got shot the first time and walked out and recorded in 6 days. There may be some element of truth what the man writes about, but at the same time, majority of it is kufr. Leads on to what? Violence. A 19-year-old boy in Texas shot a sheriff. When they said to him, what drove you to kill this police officer? He said, listening to Tupac's track, Two Apocalypse Now, about gunning down the law. That's how some of us begin to think, isn't it? Listening to this, isn't it? That I'm above the law. What's the whole history? If you go back to the history, all begins with people like NWA, niggers with an attitude, Public Enemy, Ice-T, Ice Cube, coming back with all these other artists that begin to exist. Muslims, they think they're black. At least a black man, a Jamaican Yadi, Jamaican Patois, his language, man. He's grown up in that language. He speaks Yadi because he's a Yadi. Since when have you been a Yadi, tutting your teeth, growing dreads, wearing a Rasta vest? Since when? Since when's that been your culture? That's man's culture. That's his lifestyle. That's how he conducts himself. You ain't no Jamaican Yadi. And when you pick beef with Jamaican Yadi, you know what happens to you anyway. You get put in your place and you drive back to your streets around here in Alum Rock, don't you? Don't travel out to Hanworth and deal with the situation, do you? Put your head down and drive back where you belong. Stay in your manor, yet little boy. You ain't no bad boy if that's what you think. Because there's always going to be a badder boy than you out there. That's the reality. Most times you have to walk about with a piece behind you. You're worried about your life. That's what you're worried about. That next man's going to gun me down. Why is next man going to gun you down? Because you jacked this, he jacked that. Jacking each other. Forget about Trident. Black on black crime. We've got now Muslim on Muslim crime. Police investigating amongst ourselves. Turf wars about drugs taking place. £40 million heroin connection in Bradford. I know how much exists in this community, but I wouldn't be mistaken. There is a lot of pimps, man. Grow up with you. Racketeering and prostitution. Filth, that's what you are. You're a scum, bruv. You're a scum. I wouldn't spit on your face. My saliva's worth more than that, and you think you're a bad boy. That's how low you've become. Racketeering these substances. Getting your old Muslim youth addicted to it. Remember this one message in your life. Don't forget about that next man out there searching for you, looking for you. Think about those people you are addicted to these substances. I don't often get up and pray at night. That's my downfall. But I tell you one thing. If I knew somebody in my family got offered drugs because of you, and I know who you are, I'll make sure I get up every single night and I'll curse you till the day I die. And that's what a lot of mothers are doing upon you every single night. Remember those words. Every day you've been trafficking drugs inside this community, there's a poor mother out there who gets up every single night and says, may that person die a dog's death who got my son, my daughter addicted to this crack, this junk. It's all about cream, isn't it? What's cream? Who can tell me what cream means? Who's a rap artist here? Go on. Cash rules everything around me. That's what it's all about, isn't it? Rap about that, isn't it? And what do their mums say when they rap about that? Boy, you never lived in no shanty town, in no hut, and had no food, and you just start serving crack to get by? Is that what they said about who is it? Biggie, isn't it? Notorious, wasn't he? What happened to Biggie 6 months later after Tupac Amaru Shakur? Got gunned down as well 4 times. I wonder who gunned him down. He was notorious, wasn't he? And his mum said he never lived in no shanty town. He had damn good food given to him. And my man raps about it to serve up crack to get by. It's a fake image. And Muslim youth want to look up to that and think, yeah, that's me. Boy, there ain't no Muslim youth who's going to reach that level. We had Apache Indian, isn't it? That's about it, isn't it? That's as far as we got. So I don't understand. At least they have a talent, isn't it? They have a skill, isn't it, to talk about something. What are you going to talk about? The side of my plate, I want chutney. Boy, you ain't getting that in Belmarsh, bruv. Man sits in his cell weeping away. Shit, get me out of here, bruv. Bruv, you got yourself in here, ride it big time. Ride it is what I say. You're a man out there, ride your sentence like a man. Ride it like a man all the way then. Don't you think that these people don't know what's going on? I'm a no one. And I'm telling you now, give me 10 minutes in Alum Rock and I'll give you the names and the places of all the big traffickers in this community. So you're telling me 5-0 don't know who's who? Is that what you're trying to tell me? That 5-0 don't know who's doing what? Of course they know.